Hey guys, it's Andrew Carr right here. I hope you're having a fantastic, fabulous TGIF Friday. Here's your daily stimulus check, second stimulus check, third stimulus check, fourth stimulus check. For some people, their fifth stimulus check. Executive order, executive action, and stimulus package update for Friday, May 28th, 2021. Find out how a report from the IRS indicates how $1.7 trillion in stimulus checks have been left unsent. Yes, just sitting there. Boy, that money needs a home. Why over 70% of the House Democrats are putting pressure on Biden to follow through on his campaign promise. And why President Biden is warning the GOP, you better, yes, he's calling out the GOP not to get in the way as talks for another stimulus package are heating up. Find out what's coming after this. For the best news and information to master, dominate, and elevate your money, your business, and your life, stay tuned to this channel. Awesome giving away money here. $1,900 in cash. All you got to do, like, subscribe, comment. That's all. It's free. Doesn't cost you anything. We hit 190,000 subscribers, and we're launching out $1,900. We refill the bank, and then probably launch out like $2,000. Also, down below, you can get stocks right now by clicking on the Weeble link. Get two free stocks. It's in the description. You could get those two free stocks worth up to $1,800 for free. It's a limited time offer, so don't miss out on that. And also to my Patreons who get 5 articles a week, update on my portfolio and everything that's going on. Thank you guys for participating for as little as $3. And also don't forget about we're about to stop the promotion on the real estate program. $99 for a limited time offer, $4,000 course. I spent over $45 million learning all this stuff. When to buy, how to buy, what to buy, especially right now from a real estate expert. I'm a broker, business broker, and also have a banking license. So make sure you check out my real estate course. But first, a staggering 1.24 million stimulus checks are still left unsent. I hope you're not one of those people from the first stimulus package, which totals around $1.7 billion. Yes, a lot of people have not seen their money. It's amazing, unbelievable. According to reports from the IRS, California, which has the highest population in the US, as you may know, has the most unsent checks of any state with 123,265, followed by Florida with 92,000. So if you know somebody who hasn't got a check out there, make sure they tap into the IRS site. Next in line is Texas, New York, and Pennsylvania. The 1.24 million unsent payments represent, quote, the number of people who either refuse to accept it, like, I don't want it, paid back, or have not cashed their stimulus checks they received from the IRS as a result of the CARES Act that was signed into the law by Congress May 27, 2020. You remember that? Long time ago now, right? Like 14 months? Our only question is how money was left over after the second and third stimulus package. Well, what happened? Where'd it go? And if the IRS has that money, what do they do with it? Meanwhile, a large coalition of White House Democrats launched a campaign to ramp up pressure on President Biden, calling him out to follow through on expanding Medicare in the American Family Plan. A total of 156 House Democrats, which, you know, I think there's about 216, so that's majority of the House Democrats, are, you know, ranging from moderates to progressives, signed a letter requesting the administration lower the eligibility for Medicare, decrease prescription drug costs, and expand coverage for dental, vision, and hearing. The signatures of the letter represent more than 70%. That's a big number of the House Democrats. Wonder what happened to the other 30? Like, where'd they go? The lawmakers request that the Medicare starting age be lowered. Yes, lowered to 60, allowing at least 23 million Americans to join the program at a cost of $2 billion over a decade. And for those struggling to actually make ends meet at 60 and can't afford healthcare because it's so expensive, boy, this is critical. As healthcare has been a key issue in Democrats, they're asking Biden administration to include these measures in the plan. for all my seniors out there, I hope this goes for you. I know that we have a pretty big audience too of seniors. We got everybody across the board. But to you guys, I hope that you guys get this. And finally, President Biden is warning the GOP, quote, not to get in the way, end quote. Ooh, bold words. Of his big infrastructure plans, he's got big dreams. During a tour of a manufacturing technology center in Cleveland, heart of America, right? One of the hearts of America, Biden held up a card containing the names of Republican lawmakers who rejected his aid bill in Washington, but rather promoted it when they were back home in front of voters. Very interesting, huh? Keeping people accountable? Biden stated, quote, I'm not going to embarrass anyone, although he did, but I have here a list. If we're going to take credit for what we've done, don't get in the way of what we need to do, end quote. So it's almost like they lied to their voters, right? And said, hey, give me a vote, but I'm not behind this bill, even though I'm saying that I am. Sounds like politics, right? Talks are at crossroads right now before Memorial Day deadline is to make a progressive towards a bipartisan deal. That plan is sign a bill before Memorial Day so that we can party it up on Memorial Day for having done that. Biden reduced his $2.3 trillion, I guess, in the air of trying to meet in the middle, his opening bid of $1.7 trillion in earlier negotiations, while the GOP is still stuck at that proposal of $928 billion infrastructure proposal as a counteroffer that I covered yesterday. The White House press secretary said Biden and Senator Shelley Moore Capitola of West Virginia, the leading Republican negotiator, is expecting to meet next week while Congress is on break. So they get to get in their PJs and go home, not their pajamas, their private jets, and go home and be in front of their voters while the people in Washington try and break bread and figure out how they get this thing across the finish line. So when they come back, people can actually vote and actually get something done, and the country could actually get moving again. That was your stimulus check, second stimulus check, and executive action and stimulus package update for T, G, and the I, and the F, Friday, May 28, 2021. Thank you so much for watching and for making it to the end. Please leave a comment with your plans for the long weekend. What are you gonna do? I'm Andrew Cartwright. Please stay safe out there. Take care, because I love you.